Hey, all curious mind, I found an interesting thing. I think it might be fun if I share it with you. If I say x to the power 10 is equal to 10, would you believe? Okay, there is no clue, nothing, right? This is not interesting thing until now. So this is not only the thing that I'm going to show you. If I say not only x to the power 10 is equal to 10, x to the power x at that to the power 10 is also equal to 10. This is equal to 10, that is equal to 10, and that's not the end. I have something more as well. X to the power x did, and then another x, and then that to the power 10 is equal to 10. It seems like insane thinking, right? How does it possible? X to the power x is 10, x to the power x and that to the power 10 is equal to 10, and then again I'm adding another x as a power, that's also equal to 10. How does it possible, right? I will prove in next few minutes that this is equal to 10, that is also 10, and that is also equal to 10. Well, just stick with me. In order to prove this part, let's go step by step. So let's consider this is the first step. X to the power 10 is equal to 10. So if I rework on left hand side and right hand side, it become x is equal to 10 to the power 1 over 10. If I replace this x on this part and this whole part, it become 10. How does it possible? Let's go in the second step. Let's rewrite this part. X to the power 10 is equal to, if I replace this x by 10 to the power 1 over 10, then it become, this x is here, this x means 10 to the power 1 over 10, and this 10 is exactly here. Look at here, this 10 and that 10, they cancel from our system, and remaining is x to the power only 10. And again, I can replace this x by 10 to the power 1 over 10. That means this x is 10 to the power 1 over 10, and this 10 is power here. Again, the same way, this 10 denominator and numerator, they cancel from our system, and remaining is 10 only, which means x to the power x to the power 10 is equal to this 10. Now check the fact, x to the power x, that to the power x to the power 10 is equal to, let's replace the value of x. X means 10 to the power 1 over 10. This x means 10 to the power 1 over 10. This x means again 10 to the power 1 over 10. And this x means 10 to the power 1 over 10, whole power is 10. This is totally different things, right? This to the power whole and that to the power this part. So look at here, this 10 and that 10, they cancel each other. And then this 10 and that 10 also cancel each other. And this 10, that 10 cancel each other. And at the end, remaining is only 10. That means I am showing here x to the power x to the power x to the power 10 is equal to 10. Yes, that's the things I wanted to show you at the beginning, right? So I proved here x to the power x and that to the power x is equal to 10. That's not only the things. By the same way, you can prove x to the power 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 10 is equal to 10 at the same way. I have another interesting thing to show you. Let's say a simple mathematical statement, minus 9 minus 21 divided by minus 3 is multiplied by 2. What's the value of this part? It's very simple. I know 90% people would say this is very simple, you can calculate it, right? But my question is not that thing. If I follow the rules of Bodmash, the result, and if I do not follow the rules of Bodmash, the result is also the same. That means there is no difference if I follow or don't follow the Bodmash rules. That I'm gonna to show you. Let's say at the beginning, I don't apply any Bodmash rules. In that case, this equation, let's rewrite it here. Minus 9 minus 21 divided sign and then minus 3 times 2. So I can rewrite this part like this way. Minus 9 plus minus 21 divided sign minus 3, 2. So in this part, I am not applying any Bodmash rules. In this case, let's say minus 9 minus 21, which is equals to minus 30 divided sign, and then 3 times 2 is minus 6. This minus and that minus, they cancel from our system, and 30 divided by 6 means this is 5. That is the result. So I got the result of this mathematical statement 5 without applying any Bodmash rules. In this case, we have to apply the Bodmash rules. That means we have to work out on this part first. Minus 9 remaining the same plus minus 21 divided by minus 3, which is equal to plus 7 times 2. And if we follow the Bodmash rules, and second time we have to work out on this part. That means minus 9 plus 7 times 2 is 14. So minus 9 plus 14, which is equals to 5. I wanted to show you that if you apply the Bodmash rules, result, and if you don't apply the Bodmash rules, result, both are same. That I show you here. What I wanted to say in this mathematical statement is, if you apply the order of operation, so-called Bodmash, the result is same. If you do not apply the Bodmash rules, result is also the same. That I wanted to say. Okay, I should make something clear at this point of my video. This is what I shown in this video is just exception, very much exception. That means it doesn't work in mathematics every time. So you have to follow Bodmash rules in your mathematical calculation. Otherwise, your calculation will be wrong totally. This is what I did here is totally exception. Okay, I want to discuss another thing here. I made another video, and in that video I proved that 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. Yes, I got over 4 million views in that video. Yes, it is one of the popular video in my channel. But I asked a question in that video where I made the intentional mistake in this calculation. Most of the guys, you says the common thing that I did not follow the Bodmash rules. In that video, at the end, I got the calculation like this way. 4 times 5. After some step of this calculation, I got like this way. So where is the origin of this mistake? You can try it, and the link is given in this video. You can have a look. Thank you so much for watching, and see you again next time. Bye-bye.